All right, guys, welcome to Outside the Stadium Sports. We got big news this week with Hall of Fame announcing Kevin Garnett, Tim Duncan, Kobe. So that's the first part of our talk. Then next is Chris Bosh, a first ballot Hall of Famer. We're going to discuss that, looking at the accolades and see if he's deserving. And next, we're going to go into the top five power forwards of all time. You know, this is a juicy topic because us three disagree. I'm Harry. The glass is D-Row. Kush is in the blue shirt.
What's going on, boys? I'm here with our unofficial sponsor, Sam Adams, the Cold Snap. I'm here for you guys to stay bright and lively in this in this cold and desolate time. So cheers, boys. Let's get into it.
Cheers. All right. So I guess we'll start it off by just congratulating probably arguably the best Hall of Fame class of all time, Duncan, Kobe, and Garnett. I think we have a little bit of a debate as to who the best is. So I'm going to just kick it off and say that I think that Duncan is number one on this list. I know that might be tough for people to stomach because of what's gone on with Kobe and the unfortunate circumstances with that. But I just want to hear your guys' opinion before we jump into who you guys got.
I got Kobe the whole way.
Kush?
Yeah, most definitely Kobe. It's Kobe for me.
Okay. So I guess we'll just start off by saying that since none of us have Garnett, I love Garnett. He brought my team a championship. He brought the Celtics a ring, but I don't think he is on the same level as Duncan or Kobe. You all agree on that?
Yeah, but we can give Garnett credit for starting that era of superstars demanding to be traded and getting their way to a new team.
That's fair. It's always nice to be remembered for something. So now I'm messing. He's obviously a legend. But I'll just talk about a little about why I think Duncan is number one in this class, and then you guys can kind of argue me on that. So I think we all know Duncan and Kobe probably have opposite personalities. Kobe was like the loudest guy, while Duncan didn't really care about all these things. So if you go in terms of statistics, if you go across the lines, I think in the statistics that matter, Duncan has has the W in this. So if you look at All-Star games, I know Kobe has that. But if you look at every other category, in my opinion, that are important, like MVPs, Duncan has two to Kobe's one. Finals MVPs, Duncan has three to Kobe's two. All defense, Duncan has 15 to Kobe's 12. Duncan also has a Rookie of the Year, and obviously they have the same amount of championships. So, I mean, getting two MVPs is a huge deal, in my opinion. Like, Kobe and Garnett have the same amount of MVPs. Like, that's not to belittle, either of them. But, like, getting over that hump of two MVPs, not many people in the league have that. And I think finals MVP, that's something that obviously Duncan really cared about. Like, for example, All-Star MVPs, All-Star Game MVPs, like, there's no way Duncan cared about that. He has one to Kobe's four, so obviously Kobe has a nod there. But in my opinion, in categories that really, really count, Duncan has the edge here.
Listen, you're right with the accolades. You can't even argue, he has more accolades besides All-Star Games. But at the end of the day, Kobe changed the game. The amount of clutch shots, the amount of people even screaming Kobe. Everyone knows who Kobe Bryant is. Yes, to be fair, Tim Duncan, Mr. Fundamental and everything. But at the end of the day, who's getting the ball? Game 7, 30 seconds left of the game. That's Kobe being Bryant. He gets the ball, one of the best clutch players of all time. He's taken teams. Tim Duncan, he did the same system, Popovich, relatively the same players, Parker, Ginobili, Bruce Bowen, just a great all-around team around him. Not to say that Shaq's not good. Shaq's one of the best centers of all time. But, Pau Gasol, he's no chump either. He's an all-star, great player. But he's not a guy that I think you're going to ride as your Robin to the championships and win it all. Without Kobe Bryant there, that team is not going to the championships, let alone winning that championship. And I think Kobe all
so you think you think Kobe's more important to his team than Duncan was to his team?
Absolutely. Kush?
Firstly, I just got to make a small point is that, Kobe Bryant might have less MVPs, but you got to look at that 2004-05 season when most people would agree that Kobe was probably deserving and they gave it to 15.5 points per game, Steve Nash. But, because they wanted to reward the Suns, I get it. I hear that. And my argument is just that, when we talk about who's the greatest, I looked at what greatness means. It says the quality of being great or distinguished. And you said it yourself, Duncan does not have the loudest personality. That's his style. When we talk about distinguishing yourself from the others, people grew up falling away and screaming Kobe. Kobe developed the Mamba mentality. You know, Kobe Bryant was the one who was known to like work out with players in the off season. Kobe Bryant was the one who was waking up at 5 a.m. I'm not saying Duncan wasn't, but I'm saying Kobe Bryant actively distinguished himself in almost every aspect of his basketball life, not just in the games. And then within the games, greatness, distinguishing is for me moments and clutch shots. And while Duncan did have, you know, definitely his own, Kobe was definitely more pronounced for that.
Rosen, you got any counter to this?
The only thing that I was thinking is when we talk about like the best at their position, right? I think that we can all agree that Kobe wasn't the best at his position all time. I think we can all agree on that. But I will say that in our third segment of like the best power forwards of all time, all of us unanimously did have Duncan on our lists. So I think that when you're putting up a team or assembling a team like together and you're like talking to your boys, like give me your top five all time, like Kobe usually doesn't make the cut there either. So, you know, obviously, again, you can argue this all day, but I think if Duncan was as loud as Kobe, obviously he wasn't. I think, you know, we were riding the Duncan.
Yeah, if Duncan was as loud as Kobe, if Mickey Mantle never got injured, if Biggie Smalls never died.
Is Chris, on a side note, is Chris Bosh worthy of a first ballot?
I say yes, strong yes over here. What do you guys think?
I agree with you on this one. I think Chris Bosh deserves it, honestly. Kush?
I'm going to say no. I don't think he's definitely a Hall of Famer without a doubt. He does not deserve to be on this ballot with Kevin Garnett, Kobe Bryant, and Tim Duncan.
Fair.
Rosen, you're very passionate about it, so let's hear.
Yeah, so I'm a pretty big Celtics guy, and I want to just compare Bosh to a first ballot Hall of Famer. I think we all have a first ballot Hall of Famer to compare him to, but I'm going to throw him up against McHale. Personally, I have a McHale signed picture in my room. Like, I love Kevin McHale, but I do not think that he was as good as Chris Bosh. If you go through the stats, just to talk a little bit about Bosh, he's 11-time All-Star. I'm pretty sure those were 11 straight years where he was an All-Star. One-time All-NBA, two-time champion, All-Rookie team, and he finished his career averaging 19-8. McHale, 7-time All-Star, 3-time champ, again, was probably on the top five team with Larry and Parrish and those guys. He has 2 Sixth Man of the Year awards, but Bosh never had that opportunity because he was starting every game. All-Rookie team, 6-time All-D, and All-NBA. Bosh finished his career on average with more points and rebounds than McHale. And if you want to talk about Batman and Robin and then Bosh and Batman and Robin and then McHale, I still think no matter how you put it, Chris Bosh was a better overall player than Kevin McHale. And Kevin McHale was a first ballot Hall of Famer. So I 100% think Bosh should have been a first ballot Hall of Famer. I think if the tragedy didn't happen to Kobe, he wouldn't have been in this class, obviously, and Bosh would have 100% been in the class.
So I agree with you here. I just want to say this. Bosh was part of arguably the biggest play of NBA history. Bosh rebound to Ray Allen, game 6, then the Heat win the whole championship in game 7. I mean, Bosh, he's just always going to be remembered. Unfortunately, his career was cut short from blood clots in his lungs, and, you know, the sky was the limit for him. Like, who knows if the Heat would have broke up then. You know, he could have, you know, went to a different team. He was on the Raptors in the beginning of his career, and I just think, you know, comparing him to Grant Hill, for example, who's another first ballot Hall of Famer, Bosh had a better longevity with his stats throughout his career, and, you know, he has the championships to talk, and he's very deserving. Kush?
I agree. He's much better than Grant Hill also, just throwing it out there.
Yeah,
Harry, I just want to give you credit. I mean, you definitely have to give Bosh credit for, with that one play, literally changing the trajectory of the next, you know, 5 to 10 seasons of the NBA. You know, who knows, if he doesn't make that rebound and the Heat burn out 2 seasons in a row, they might not stay together. LeBron might not have, dare I say, any titles right now. I mean, and that's an argument we definitely could have. That's an argument we definitely could have in the future. But, yeah, I mean, I'm not saying Chris Bosh is in a crapshoot, not a first ballot Hall of Famer. I'm saying this year he's not a first ballot Hall of Famer. You know, Bill Bradley is a first ballot Hall of Famer, but he was on a ballot with Dave DeBusschere, who played for the Pistons and Knicks, had a solid career, and Jack Timon, who probably none of us know, who played for the Royals back in the day. That's why Bill Bradley was a Hall of Famer, first ballot. But when you look at Bosh and comparing him to these three, you know, we got Kobe Bryant with, you know, 172.7 win shares, and we have Tim Duncan with 206.4 and Kevin Garnett with 191.4, and Bosh is respectable with 106, but not.
Wait, so you're saying that it's because of those other guys that he's not in the Hall of Fame?
I'm saying he's not a first ballot Hall of Famer this year.
It's tough to stomach a little bit.
No, it's tough to stomach, but if you had, you know, that he would, dare I say, dilute that class.
All right, staying on the topic, we're talking about power forwards here. You know, who's your top five power forwards of all time?
You want me to kick this one off?
You got this.
All right. It's very tough. I think we all, if I recall, we all have the same top two. I think number one, like I kind of mentioned before, Duncan being the best at his position. But to follow him up, we got Malone, who just – his numbers are just absurd, just crazy numbers this guy put up. But obviously Jordan kept him from winning any championship, so that's always going to taint him. I think he's – him and Barkley are the only guys that don't have a ring on my list. Three, I'm going to give to Garnett. You know, he's my boy. He brings championship to Boston. Four, I'm going to go with Chuck. I'm going to go with Charles Barkley at four, who was fantastic and also was in the era when he just couldn't win a ring while Jordan was running that team. And then five, I'm going to give it to the guy who led the worst championship team in history to get a ring somehow. I still don't understand how he did it, but I'm going to give that to Dirk at number five. That's my list.
So I got the same two in agreement, the first two. But, you know, you got to give number three to Dirk. He had that fadeaway shot, unbelievable shot, him beating the big three in the Miami Heat fresh. That's a fresh team. All together,
it's pretty impressive.
I wouldn't say all in their prime, but LeBron near his prime there. Wade's definitely in his prime. Bosh, right from the Raptors. You got to give Dirk number three. And then I had a big debate here between Garnett and Barkley, but at the end of the day, the rings speak. Garnett gets it from me. You know, the stats are pretty similar, and Garnett has the ring. Garnett gets the edge for me.
Yeah, so I mean, I definitely have the same first two as you guys. It's Tim Duncan at number one, just because of the accolades, you know, the team accolades, the finals. He definitely takes the cake over Karl Malone, regardless of his ridiculous stats. I will mention for Karl Malone, not that we're playing the what if game, but I do think he was fouled by Jordan on that strip, and then that did, you know, literally that could have literally altered an entire NBA final, so he could have a ring. But and yeah. After that, I'm playing Charles Barkley at three. Only because I like to look at how players change the game when it's very close. And you know, Charles Barkley was the first player. You know, this dude was not a tall guy, but he was physical and down there with all the big men. He is the precedent for Zion Williamson, whereas Dirk Nowitzki is more of a precedent for Kristaps Porzingis, which is a great player. But I just think Charles Barkley did more to revolutionized the way the NBA game was being played than Dirk Nowitzki. So I have Duncan, Malone, then Charles Barkley, then Dirk, and then Kevin Garnett, only because he goes behind Dirk, because I think Dirk's finals win was a little bit more iconic than Kevin Garnett's.
And we're all too young to mention Bob Pettit, so we'll just keep him out of the conversation. But he has two MVPs. You mentioned that right there.
Cheers.
The only thing I want to add in with Dirk is, you know, he was one of the first big guys that's shooting threes. He kind of revolutionized the big men shooting threes. So I think going back to impact, saying Kobe's one of the best scorers and he had such a big impact on the game. So Dirk, he changed the game for big men. Don't say first,
because I'm gonna jump in for the bad boy Pistons and Bill Laimbeer, man. He was the first one. He was the first one to do it that frequently, but not the first one to do it. He was not the first to do it.
That's true.
I think that's good. If anyone has any fans, comment your top five lists. I'd love to hear what other people have to say here. Tune in more for next week's segment. We're going to probably have more basketball talks. You know, anything that comes out at the Hall of Fame or any, you know, controversies, baseball, basketball, football, we will be covering it. You know, thank you very much for tuning in.